Hey PATS, we are so glad you tuned in to our March episode of PATS TV.
As we spring into our last 9 weeks, there are tons of things blooming at Hillcrest.
We're starting off strong with an update from Mia on spring happenings at the Crest and coverage of the Powderpuff Games from Nicole.
Then, Brooke and Avery share our final wrap on basketball and a look at our spring sports.
And in our feature story, Mr. Jones will be revealing next year's musical for the Hillcrest Theater Department.
And Brooklyn finishes us off with some important prom do's and don'ts.
I'm Julia Marshall.
And I'm Mahana Carnathan.
And this is your
PATS TV.
Hillcrest spring updates, and Nicole gives a recap of the Powderpuff Games.
Hi, PATS. As we all know, the most exciting part about high school is getting to experience the different activities that we have. So let's get to the ones we have going on at Hillcrest.
First, we have prom coming up April 7th at the River Market from 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock p.m. Be sure to come dressed to impress. Next, the juniors have the ACT at Hillcrest on April 11th. If you want to be prepared for the ACT, log into Cantrell and Waller to learn strategies and get more familiar with the test. On April 12th, the Chick-fil-A Leader Academy is hosting their annual field day. Their goal is to raise $10,000 to help fund the Rise Against Hunger campaign. Come out to have a good time and help the Chick-fil-A Leader Academy achieve their goal. The band will have a spring concert on May 2nd at 6 o'clock p.m. in the theater. And our very own theater department is hosting a theater showcase May 5th that's also in the theater. If you have nothing to do that Friday night, come out and have fun with us. Graduation will be held at the amphitheater on May 19th. Say goodbye to the end of the beginning of it all. We'll miss you, seniors.
Make sure to mark these dates down on your calendar. This is Mia Mixon reporting for your PATS TV.
Hey PATS TV, I'm Nicole, and today's event is the Powerpuff Game at Hillcrest High School 2023, where you see there's four sections of where the grade levels are separated. Freshmen are wearing white, sophomores are wearing red, and juniors are wearing blue, and finally, seniors are wearing black.
Of the experience some of the players had at the Powerpuff Games.
I had no good experiences because I tried to make a deep ball pass to Naisha Davis and she didn't catch the ball twice.
Phillip Davis, the icon of Hillcrest. I ate per usual. It's really hard carrying three men, okay?
I'm over SGA, our Student Government Association here at Hillcrest, and honestly, it was just something that the students brought forth, and it was such a fun game to include everybody, let people have fun, let people do something that they normally could, letting girls play football and our guys play, be cheerleaders, just get really everyone into like a school spirit in the springtime when we always have everything in the fall time. So yeah.
Down, 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 up, up, up.
2023 Powerpuff Game event that happened at Hillcrest High School. Come back for more next year. Now I have to go to class. Nicole signing off.
That is so awesome. Was that Morgan as a QB?
We're not gonna talk about that. Let's move on to our current and more qualified athletes.
Yes, let's go to Brooke and Avery.
Hi Pat, it's Brooke, and I'm here with your basketball season wrap-up.
The boys team went 20-13 this year. They made the state tournament and made it to the Elite Eight. In the first round, they beat Hueytown 62-51 and headed to the Sweet 16. In the Sweet 16, they beat Chilton 52-50 in overtime and headed to the Elite Eight, where they sadly lost to Bryant 61-50. Patriot Nation is looking forward to seeing this team rebuild and grow for the next season. The girls' basketball team went 28-6 this season with notable wins over Pelham, Oxford, and Hoover. They reached the Final Four this year, only the third time in school history. They started their tournament run beating McAdory in the first round 48-30. In the Sweet 16, they beat Briarwood Christian 53-22 to head to Elite Eight, where they beat Pelham 57-45. Sadly, their tournament run ended in the Final Four. They lost 56-50 against Huffman in a nail-biter. The girls' basketball team has accomplished so much this season. We are looking forward to seeing how they grow next season. Congrats to freshman Blakely Nixon on being named a part of the 6A State Finals All-Tournament team and making the ASWA All-State team, along with fellow teammate sophomore Drea Branch. They both also made the Tuscaloosa County All-Area team, with Nick Browser being named Coach of the Year. I got the chance to talk to Athletic Director and Assistant Principal Brad Armstrong about the student support during the boy and girl tournament runs.
But you guys got the chance to take a bunch of students from school and travel to the Crossplex and let them all see what's going on there. So is there anything that, you know, you or the like other administrators have learned from taking students from school and there, anything you would do different next time or anything like that?
Well, first of all, we always want student interaction, and we really like when our kids are involved. It's a real team effort for our faculty and our administrators and the coaches, but ultimately the kids show up. And, you know, the kids want to go. They want to support the team. I mean, when we went to Birmingham for the Final Four, we took 8 buses of students. 8. I mean, we had over 300 kids that we transported. That's not even counting the kids that transported themselves. So the number of kids that support athletics here at Hillcrest High School is just a phenomenal number. It's a really large number. I mean, I'd put our student support and the number of people that care about athletics here at Hillcrest High School up there with any other school in the state. And, you know, it certainly tops any place in West Alabama. And we know that. The wins that we have, the success that we've had, I mean, we know that we are the top athletic program in this area. But we want to continue to be that way. But we're not really worried about West Alabama, to be honest with you. Our goal is to be the best in the state. And, you know, being representing Tuscaloosa County is great. But ultimately, we want to represent Alabama as one of the top programs in the state.
Congrats to the boys and girls on their amazing basketball season. This is Brooke for PATS TV.
Hey Pats, this is Avery Hill, and I'm here to give you your spring sports updates.
Softball, we getting rocking and rolling pretty much. We hitting kind of the middle of our season, so I think we're going to have an awesome season this year, and we're just loving it and have fun. So I expect to have a lot of good times, and expect everybody to be involved around the community.
You know, we've already started. We started way back on January 9th was the first practice, and then the first match was somewhere around February 1st. So actually, today is the 28th, I believe, of March, and we play Northridge today, and then we're basically about the last quarter of our season. If everything goes well, as we expect it to, 4 weeks from yesterday and 4 weeks from today will be the state tournament. So we do have some important tournaments coming up. We got one in Decatur this coming weekend. Then we get a little bit of a break, and then sectionals will be at Northridge the following week. And then, as I said, state is the week following it.
Both girls and guys have been looking really good so far. Girls had their first area win on Tuesday over Central. They won 5-1. And then boys will start their area next week. And so we expect them to make it to playoffs and to do really well this season.
Well, right now we're just trying to just get more consistent each and every day. Play better baseball every day that we take the field. But as far as the season goes, man, we're looking to continue what we've done in the past and put together a good run at the end of the year and just kind of enjoy the season, but at the same time, just compete, see what our guys got, and see how far away I can take us.
On March 25th at the Northridge Invitational, the Hillcrest men's 4x100 relay team finished in second place. Hillcrest also won the silver medals in men's 100-meter dash and 400-meter sprint.
Well, there you have it. This has been Avery Hill with your PATS TV.
It's hard to believe that it's Easter basket season now and not basketball basket season.
Right. This year is just hopping by. In fact, Mr. Jones is already revealing the theater department's show for next year.
Yes, let's go see what he's planning over there.
Maybe some of you have seen some of the fantastic musicals put on by Hillcrest Theater over the past several years. Mr. Jones, and as you may or may not have noticed, there has been a battle for supremacy between 8 popular musicals, all vying for the right to be the next great musical presented by Hillcrest Theater Department in the second semester of the 23-24 school year. We call it March Musical Madness. The 8 finalists were matched up in round 1 of March Musical Madness and its bracket. Those matchups included SpongeBob Musical versus You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. Schoolhouse Rock versus Clue the Musical. The Little Mermaid versus Godspell. And Honk versus Annie. A school-wide March Madness bracket competition has been going on as students from all around the school have submitted their brackets in hopes of winning the prizes that you see listed here. The winners from round 1 were SpongeBob the Musical, Schoolhouse Rock, The Little Mermaid, and Honk. So, after narrowing it down to the final 4, the matchups were between SpongeBob and Schoolhouse Rock, and The Little Mermaid and Honk. Moving on to the championship round were the 2 underwater shows, SpongeBob and The Little Mermaid. Maybe we'll just turn the theater into a huge aquarium. Do our show completely underwater next year. Oh yeah, there's the whole breathing thing, so I guess that won't work. So, now it is time to announce the winner of March Musical Madness and the name of the show that Hillcrest Theater will be performing next year. By the way, I know there are tons of you talented students out there who want to get involved and join in on the fun of being in our show. Now, keep this in mind, you don't have to be in theater class to audition. It's open to the whole school. Although I would love for you to be in the class and you would enjoy it. But anyway, it's open to the whole school. Okay, drum roll please. And the winner is The Little Mermaid. Yes, next January, Hillcrest Theater will proudly present The Little Mermaid, the musical. Don't you miss it. This is Mr. Jones for PATS TV.
Oh man!
Julia, what's wrong?
My bracket got busted.
That's okay. Let's just cheer you up with some prom talk with Brooklyn.
Tonight, I just want to take you home.
Put your pinky rings up to the moon.
champagne colored with silver glitter.
Wait, what kind of shoes are you wearing?
They're like, you know, they're
heels. Hey, girls, we have a show to do. Thank you.
Right.
I'm Julia Marshall.
And I'm Mahana Carnathan.
And this was your
PATS TV.
Hey, PATS, we are so glad you've turned into our March episode of PATS TV.
Wait, we're so glad you what?
Did I say turned again? Is this just going to be the exact...
How are people turning into the episode?
I don't know, man. Don't ask me. Oh, man.
Julia, what's wrong?
Why are you laughing?
I can't think
Julia,
that
up. What's wrong?
I know. I can't think it's something serious.
Julia, what's wrong?
Oh.
Julia, what's wrong?
Okay, tell me when.
Okay. Oh, didn't wait. Right there.
Here?
Yeah, that's good. All right,
still rolling.
Oh, man.
Julia, what's wrong?
My bracket got busted.
That's all right. Let's cheer you up with some prom talk with...
What's the line? Say the line.
That's all right. Let's just cheer you up with some prom talk with Brooklyn.
Okay. I can't wait for prom season. What are you wearing, Mahana?
I'm wearing this long dress, right? And it has like...
Really? What kind of shoes are you wearing? No!
I can't wait to see the...